All right, so good morning, good afternoon, good evening, whatever time of day it is. For this section, we are going to be focusing on designing an island of thought and recuperation. The basic things that are going to be required is your island must be floating up in the air, and then you must have you. So these are all three different things that you need to design. So design your island, and you design what you look like, design a shelter, and design a partner, a character, kind of like a pet, a sidekick. That part's like mixing up those animals, the design that we were looking at the end of last term. Okay? And so the video part, what we're going to be covering today is you're going to be drawing the in perspective, a floating island. So, there we go. We're going to start off in linear perspective, as we're going to start off with, what is this called? What is it called? It's called a horizon line. So, we're going to be working in two-point perspective, just for fun. So, we have a horizon line. And then one and two. This is our vanishing points. Get those nice and established. And then I'm going to have this part. Next is we're going to do line here. That line here. And these are called orthogonals. And now it's 3:44 in the morning because I wanted to not have to do this last night. So my brain is just turning back on. So we might have to kind of fudge a couple things here. But what we've covered before in doing the house and the bridge from turn one, we'll slide this over here, we're making a rectangle cube. So anytime we have a vertical line from the top and the bottom, we go to the vanishing points from there. With orthogonals, and that creates the size, developing what's called foreshortening, which creates the illusion of depth. So one and two. Okay. We have a vertical line there. So we're going to go from the bottom to our vanishing point. And from the top to the vanishing point. Right here to here. And then we're going to line up here on this line. Slide it over to here. Way off. Still not very good. Alright. So, now comes the part where we have this framework in here. And if I had a different color to work with, it would be awesome. Anyway, I got a pen right here. Let's see if that works. Alright, so let's go ahead and in here, and there's my cord. Gonna worry about it. So in this top, we're gonna, like when we did the what are they called? Ellipse. Come in and create the outline or the contour of the top. We're filling in using the sides to bounce off of, like Pong or whatever, those old games where it would hit the wall and then bounce back. So we go, we bounce off here and there. And then what happens is this comes down, and then the bottom is going to be in that cylinder. See what's happening here. Yep. I'm gonna have some breaks and things like that there. Beautiful. Okay. And then now it's kind of like an extracted tooth. So then down here, this is gonna be kind of the hole where this ground's coming from. This is, just kind of make it up again, but this is where the island has just come from. Alright, and then this is the, get this all dark in here. On this value here, try to get that highlight, mid-tone, foreshadow, get that feeling of the extraction of the ground, and then just look at the natural form here and try to think where there'd be things that have broken away. And then I have a tree And so here's a, and then I have a waterfall. This is a rough sketch, just to kind of get an idea of what we're going to look like here. Very rough. So this is my little house, tree, my bridge, my waterfall. This is wonderful. Just wonderful. So good. Last video we talked about how mine has influenced this whole concept of an island for thought and recuperation is influenced from the Chinese culture of the hermits up in the mountains. Now generally the hermits are in this situation are monks and people who go up in the mountains to get away from, and they live up in the mountains, but that's not the purpose here. This is not to run away from life. This is to step away and have a moment of working to gain clarity and rejuvenation. See if we can make this look more like a waterfall. I don't know if that's going to happen. And so keeping that in mind, again, reviewing the last project we worked on in 3D Design 2 was focusing on developing our better understanding and discernment of what we find and are influenced by and find inspiring and are inspired by. And that project itself was meant to be kind of like an island like this, where the encouragement was to have that conversation with yourself about your influences, about your 3:55 in the morning. Your influences and I want to say aspirations, but I know that's not it. Man, I can't believe I'm forgetting. Anyway, this is, hopefully we're getting the idea. So this is where the extraction on the island is. And so what we're going to do is be making this out of foam, and then we're coating it with plaster and painting it. I just want you to get a general idea of what that's going to look like, and get think about how things are going to be up top, but most importantly, the culture of your island. Is meant for you. It's extremely important. To, and inspirations. So last time we looked at inspirations, influences. And these inspirations and influences, they guide your value. Okay. And so values are what we think are important and what we'll be focusing on with our drawings is the value or the value is the range of light and darks. Okay. So let's have that be kind of the theme. Values, the range of light and darks. It's what creates form. Value creates form in a drawing. And light influence on an object. Okay. So, the culture of your island is based off of your inspirations and your influences. Those two things guide your values. And the value is the range of light and dark. And it is, lot value is what creates the form. And the influence, it's the influence of light on an object. So we are working with drawings to design. And that will help us understand the form that we are working with. So, like in this sketch here, anytime I have this shading in here, remember that means it's going in. Wherever it's dark, that's the absence of light. And wherever there's the highlights and the midtones, that is where there's more light. The highlight is the greatest amount of light. And then this is where there'd be a lot less light. But we have your highlights, your midtones, and your core shadows. Those are the different influences light has. All right, so we'll do a quick value study for this next step.